أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وخاتم النبيين وحبيب الإله العالمين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين أما بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وآله والله bless محمد and his family وبلغ بإيماني أكمل الإيمان and raise my faith to reach the most perfect faith واجعل يقيني أفضل اليقين and make my conviction certainty to the most excellent of convictions. وَانْتَحِي بِنِيَّتِي إِلَىٰ أَحْسَنِ النِّيَّةِ and make my intention to reach to the best of intentions. وَبِعَمَلِي إِلَىٰ أَحْسَنِ الْأَعْمَالِ and my action to be the best of actions. Respected brothers and sisters, in our discussion about this beautiful dua of Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salatu wassalam, known as Dua-e Makarim al-Akhlaq. Last night we speak about Yaqeen. And we mentioned number of issues, of course, in connection with Yaqeen, concluding with the different degrees and levels of Yaqeen. And I would like to just close this discussion by one hadith from Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu wassalam, where he says that from Allah's blessing, which is least distributed, which is least distributed, minimally distributed, is Yaqeen. Means what? Means there are very few people who got this favor and blessing of Yaqeen. Anyway, the next, as I said, all these discussions are so beautiful and so wide that we can talk and talk. Anyway, then we also started our discussion about niyat or intention, and we said Islam and all divine ideologies place great emphasis on intention of amal and value of any action or deed. Basically, in divine ideologies depends on intention. What is your niyyah? What is your intention? What drive motivates you to do something? That is crucial. Now, this we discussed already in the light of verses of Quran and ahadith of Ahlul Bayt, Salamullahi Alayhi Ajmain. But again, like anything, to have really since sincere intention, it's a serious challenge. It's a serious challenge. It's very easy to claim that I want to do this thing, for example, for the pleasure of Allah. But really, honestly, frankly, if you scratch yourself, you know, you will realize that maybe there are 20, 30 different motivations and initiatives involved. One of them is pleasure of Allah. To purify your intention, whole and soul for Allah, is really a difficult job. It also requires exercise. Again, we understand from teachings of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wassalam that to achieve khulus, what we call it, sincerity of intention, it requires exercise, riyazat. Because your mind always runs away this way, that way. And it's sometimes really difficult to keep focus that why you are doing something. There are two main challenges to niyat. Number one is riya or hypocrisy. No? Big problem. That when person does things not for Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but to please other people. They will be happy to see that I am such a nice person. Which is called riya, or hypocrisy, or to show off. And the purpose is to seek pleasure of other people. In Islamic texts and teachings, this disease is basically regarded as shirk, regarded as example of shirk, to associate someone with Allah. Why? Because you stand for namaz, or I stand for namaz and salat, and I have an intention basically that I am doing it for the sake of Allah. But at the same time, I have intention that this person who is looking at me will be very nice, will be very good, because he will say, how nice, pious person I am, I make my namaz, I do my salat. You give a charity, Allah, you give a charity, and intention of that charity is to show off, that people will praise you. People will speak about you. Anyway, you know very well what is riya. I don't need to know when it is. I really want to a little bit move faster tonight, inshallah. This is one of the serious challenges. As I said, it's regarded as shirk. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَاتَّقُوا وَاجْتَنِبُوا الرِّيَا. Have fear of Allah and taqwa of Allah and avoid from riya, means hypocrisy, show off. فَإِنَّهُ شِرْكٌ بِاللَّهِ. This is basically associating partner with Allah. It's shirk. إِنَّ الْمَرَاعِي. Someone does things hypocritically to show off for the pleasure of other people. Yudra yawm al-qiyamati bi arba'ati asma. Listen to this hadith. In the day of Qiyamah, this person will be called with four different names. Ya kafir, Allahu Akbar. Ya fajir, means transgressor. Ya ghadir, someone who rebels. Ya khasir, someone who is in loss. Allah Akbar. Ya kafir, ya fajir, ya ghadir, ya khasir. Habat amal. Your all amal are gone, nullified. Labatala ajruk, and your reward is equal to zero. So just imagine, my brother, that how this thing destroys, how this thing destroys the whole value of your amal. Can I tell you something here? One important point. That in ibadat, worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's fasting, or it is salat, or it is charity, or it is zakat, or it is hajj, whatever ibadat. If someone has this issue of hypocrisy, this issue of seeking for the pleasure of other people, of course, a very, very big problem. Just this motivation of showing off, people like to show off. I want to say something very deeper here. Please, I need your attention, sisters and brothers, all of you. What we understand from teaching of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wassalam, that not only in ibadat, if you have this habit of show off is problem, even in any other matters in this dunya also, in this world, your motive, the driving force, is to show off, to be proud, to show somebody that I am someone. This is not acceptable. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that if someone built a house, nice, luxurious mansion, big house, with an intention that he want to show off to the people, what I built, to be proud of it, to show pride in that. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that same house which he built to show off will become like a ring of fire in his neck in the day of Qiyamah. Are you with me or not? This is very amazing. Normally we think that we must make namaz and salat purely for Allah, but other things, clothing, why not we can wear best of the clothing, show off what I am wearing, shoes, I don't know, house, I don't know, car, I don't know. But from this hadith we understand that no, this is a disease where your mindset is to seek pleasure of other people. When your mindset is that to see what people say, what people talk, I like people to praise me. I like people to speak about me. I want to humiliate other people. Ha, you got nothing. I got so much. Your one is nothing. My one is something. This attitude, this mindset, which is mindset of riya, is problematic for the niyat. Even niyat of any amal in this dunya. Now, somebody after this hadith which I now narrated for you and explained to you, ask Ya Rasulullah, Fakila, Ya Rasulullah, Kaifa, how it is possible that somebody builds a house for hypocrisy, for show off, for popularity, sum'atan? Qala, my Prophet explained how. Qala. In this manner, that he builds a house which is much more than his needs and requirements, and his whole motivation is to show off among his neighbors and among his family and among his brothers and so on, that I got something you don't have. That's how Allah would love. So even in amal of dunya, you know, in other words, what I'm trying to say, discussion is detailed, but very briefly I would like to draw your attention to this point, that mindset, that you are worried about pleasure of the people, you are worried about how I can prove myself, how I can sell my pride, this is problematic. This is not acceptable at all. This is a serious disease of niyat and intention and motivation. But yes, you can do a lot of big things in this world, a lot of good things in this world, but your motive should not be pleasure of the people. Your motive should not be to show off. Your motive should be right motive, right intention, right purpose in your mind. Another hadith from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, very interesting again. Now see what he says. Marra ala nabi sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam rajulun. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, somebody passed nearby Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, a man who was quite strong and very active, you know, very energetic, vibrant, active. فَقَالُوا صَحَابَ سَيْنْ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ لَوْ كَانَ هَذَا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. They said, we wish that this man who is so active, smart, fresh, vibrant, we wish all these energies was for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now listen, very interesting in this. They said that if it would have been for sake of Allah, very good, it was much better. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied very uniquely, very differently. Again, their expectation. He said, if he is active and smart and energetic and hardworking for the purpose of his family and his children, فَهُوَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. So he is on the path of Allah. He is for the sake of Allah. وَإِنْ كَانَ خَرَجَ يَسْعَى عَلَىٰ أَبْوَيْهِ شَيْخِينَ كَبِيرَيْنَ. And if he is active and energetic and putting a lot of effort because he got parents who are old and require support, فَهُوَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. So he's also on the path of Allah. وَإِنْ كَانَ خرج يسعى على نفسه يحبها. And even if he is struggling and putting a lot of energy and efforts to achieve a good life for himself and his family, also وهو في سبيل الله. Still it is good, nothing wrong. He still is on the path of Allah and for the sake of Allah. وإن كان خرج يسعى رياء ومفاخرة فهو في سبيل الشيطان. But yes, if all his effort was not for his own self, not for his family, not for his good life, or no, he's not worried. His worry, his concern is prove that I am someone to show off among the people, to prove among the people. Riyaan wa mufakhiratan. No, fahuwa fi sabilish shaitan. So indeed, he is on the path of shaitan. Allahu Akbar. I don't want to take further of your time. Quran and Prophet of Islam and Ahlul Bayt explain that your motivation should be for sake of Allah, even in the actions of dunya. Another challenge of another challenge of niyyat and intention, another disease of intention is what we call it ujub. Ujub. which means self-conceit. Look, we got riya. What is riya? When you are showing off to other people, when you are seeking pleasure of other people, want to prove yourself for other people. Okay, you want to be higher than other people. But sometimes, no, you're not worried about other people. Ujub is something else, very serious problem. What people are saying, it does not bother you. They are happy, they're not happy, they're jealous. No. That's not your problem. They're not worried with you, you are not worried. No, that's not the issue. Ujub and self-conceit is when you are happy with yourself. When you are happy with yourself. When you have excessively favorable opinion about yourself. You do something good, not because other people will praise you. No. But you feel, I'm a nice man. I've done what I was supposed to do. I'm a good man. But people are saying, not very good. No, but I'm nice. Very good. I'm doing right thing. I am. That is called ujub. That is called self-conceit. Another serious challenge for purity and sincerity of intention. Imam Khomeini, Rahmatullah Alayhi, has amazing sentence. He used to say, that's his sentence, that whatever is in this world, from corruption, from trouble, from problem, it is because of this disease of ujub, this disease of self-loving and self-liking. When you love yourself too much, when you are too much yourself, this is the problem. There's a statement of Imam, beautiful, maybe, because this discussion will further the line, it will come again. Here I'm just explaining principle, but Imam Zainul Abidin will mention it again. Imam Rahmatullah Alayhi has a very beautiful paragraph there. He says, all the troubles of this world start from this ujub. This issue of ana, I, me, myself, my, this ego, this is the root of all the troubles. You cannot travel toward Allah. You cannot take a step toward Allah if you have anything by the name of I, myself left. You have to kill yourself first of all. You have to free yourself first of all. Imam Rahmatullah, approach was that all these arrogant powers in politics today, why they act like that? Because of this ego, because of this self-love, because of this ana and I and mine. That is the source of all the problems and troubles. Hadith says that if someone got a disease of ujub, the self-conceit, the self-loving disease, qad halak, he is destroyed. He is destroyed. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I will not take your further time. Let me move to the next important issue. As I said, about ujub and about hypocrisy, there are plenty of discussions and plenty of points to talk about and speak about it. Let's move to the next one of our discussion in connection with Niyya. Very interesting. This is also another interesting discussion. So we discussed disease of Niyyat and intention, and now we are discussing qualities of Niyyat. Again, I would like to draw your attention what Imam Zainul Abidin said. whatever I'm saying, Allah is saying, wa Allah wantahi bi niyyati ila ahsanin niyyat. Oh Allah, take my intention to the best of intentions. It is indirectly saying that even those good intentions, those sincere intentions, are also of different levels and types. But oh Allah, I am asking you to give me the best of them. Now this is very interesting and probably heard before. Good intention also can have different levels, yes of course. Sincerity can have different levels, yes of course. I already mentioned to you, brothers and sisters, that sometimes we have some level of sincerity. But complete sincerity is very difficult. Very difficult. Like in Munajat Shabaniya, Imam alayhi salatu wassalam, he says, Ilahi, habli kamaulal in qita'i ilahi. O Allah, grant me complete submission to you. In qita' means to cut off. Grant me a status and condition where I am completely cut off from ghair of you, from anything other than you. That is very difficult. That's not very easy to have that attention. But again, brothers and sisters, as I said, this intention, has also different levels. Very well known hadith from Mawla Amir al-Mumineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wassalam says, but it says that there are people, and it's from inspired from Quran, of course, I don't have no time to give, but Imam says that there are people who worship Allah. Why? Because they are afraid of Jahannam and fire. Why they worship Allah? Because they are afraid of Jahannam, they are scared of Naar, fire. He says, no. Imam says, Bahaza, O Hazahi Ibadatul Abid. This is Ibadat and worship of slaves. Like slave always afraid of the master. So those people who fear, who do Ibadat of Allah out of fear, their ibadat is ibadat of slaves. And then Amir Mumin said, there are people who worship Allah out of desire for Jannah, for paradise. Because they want that garden of paradise and all the blessings there and a hood there. You just every night read in dua, Allahumma zawwij, amma bahur al-eid fazawwij. Allah marry us with the most beautiful woman there in Jannah. Right? So, some people worship Allah because of those beautiful women, because those rivers of honey and milk, because of those ni'mat and things there in paradise. Amir al-Mu'mineen says, this ibadat is ibadat of tujjar. This is ibadat of businessmen. Like businessmen always concerned about profit. So you do ibadat, but out of your desire of making profit to go to Jannah for ibadat to job. Mawla Amir al-Mumineen alayhi salatu wassalam said, but there are people who make ibadat of Allah not because they are afraid of Allah, neither they have desire of Jannah. So why they feel out? Do ibadat of Allah because they find Allah most deserving for ibadah.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad.
Because they find Allah most deserving for ibadah. And Al-Mu'min says, فَتَلْكَ عِبَادَةُ الْأَحْرَارِ. And this ibadat is ibadat and worship of free people. This is the ibadat of free people. Ahraw, free. They worship Allah not out of the fear of Jahannam. nor for the love of Jannah. They love Allah, therefore they worship Allah. So that is the highest level of niyyat, motivation. That when you are motivated because of love of Allah, because you reach to the point where you find Allah deserving to be worshipped. Are you with me or not? But let me make one quick point here. And then we will move to the next point, inshallah. That when I'm saying that some people make worship because of the fear of Jahannam, don't think that their ibadat is wrong. No, their ibadat is fine. Nothing wrong with it. Normal people cannot understand everything. Even if they make ibadat because they are afraid of Jahannam, it is fine. It is acceptable. And similarly, if some people out of the love of Jannah and woman and paradise and honey and milk and I don't know what and what and what, they make ibadat, nothing wrong. That's also fine. Don't think I'm saying it's wrong, it is fine. But the quality is not that quality. The highest quality of ibadat is that when you make ibadat, nor for the fear and neither for the love of Jannah. You do it why? You do it out of your love for Almighty Allah, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Inshallah. Brothers and sisters, now let us move to the next point where Imam alayhi salatu wa salam is saying, what he's saying, that وَبِعَمَلِي إِلَىٰ أَحْسَنِ الْأَعْمَالِ, and O Allah, take my actions to the best of actions. Take, O Allah, my actions to be the best of action. Action, we know, just now we spoke about niyyat, intention. Even hadith says that in the day of Qiyamah, people will not be rewarded based upon their actions. They will be rewarded based upon their intentions. But it does not mean, my brothers and sisters, that amal and action is not important. No, my brother. Action is also important. You cannot say, I have very good intentions, but I don't do anything, I sit and relax. No, it doesn't work like that. Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what? The verse which I have listened, recorded for you, noted. Alladhi halaqal mawta wal hayat liyablubukum ayyukum ahsanu amala. Allah is the one who created death and life to test you which of you is best in the deed. So action comes now, and it's indeed, brothers and sisters, very important that action also must be there. Imam Ibn al-Abidin is also asking for ahsan al-a'mal, for the best of actions. And with all the discussions we have now, the picture of the best of action is in front of us. Best of action is, please listen carefully, which has best of intentions behind, which has best of expression by tongue, and which has best of action, in action by organs and parts of our body. Therefore, brothers, when we speak about actions and best of actions, it is important to understand that niyyat alone is not enough, intention alone is not enough, amal. Therefore, Imam says, no benefit of amal without niyyat, and no benefit of niyyat and intention without amal. One verse of Holy Quran I would like to draw your attention, which will clarify the situation. Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what? إِلَيْهِ يَسْعَدُ الْكَلِمُ الْتَيَّبُ وَالْأَمَلُ الصَّالِحِ يَرْفَأُهُ. Means what? إِلَيْهِ means toward Allah. يَسْعَدُ means ascends, flies, goes up. What goes up? Good word. Kalimat Tayyib means good word, pure word. Okay? Wal amalu salih yarfa'u. Now the translation which I have written here is one of the translations, but not necessarily this translation. This translation says, and he elevates righteous conduct. He means who? Allah. But the other translation is more decorative. Which one? Amalu salih yarfa'u. That good conduct and good deed raises kalimu tayyib, the good word, higher. Are you with me or not? Did you get the point or not? Very delicate point. This ayat of Quran is one of those ayat which has a really great message for us. It says, kalimu tayyib means good word. Now, good word, kalimu tayyib, have a lot of different meanings. Tawheed, Iman, Aqeedah, all that is kalimat tayyib, all that is pure word, is good word. And this good word and good Aqeedah and good Iman and this good kalima ascends toward Allah, goes toward Allah, flies toward Allah. But how it flies? Who takes it high? Who raises it? Who lifts it? Your good conduct. Al-amalu salih yarfa'u. In other words, if you have kalimat tayyib, if you have good words, if you have pure words, but you don't have that lift of good conduct, sorry, it will be stuck. It will not go high. It will not ascend because the lift is not there. Lift is amalu salih. Good words must accompany good deeds. Alright. This is really, really very, very important, my brothers and sisters. Good conduct. Discussions will come further, inshallah. Another very important point, last point in this discussion, quickly to conclude, because I want to move, inshallah, in A'mal. Lot of people, sisters, brothers, lot of people can do something good. It's not that difficult. You know where is the challenge? Challenge is to sustain good character. To do once upon a time a good thing is not great. But to sustain good action and good attitude and good akhlaq, good amal and good deeds is very difficult. Hadith says from Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu was salam, al-ibqa ala al-amali hatta yakhlus ashaddu min al-amal. Imam says to sustain a good deed, to keep a good action and good deed is until final liberation, until the final, you know, resolution is more difficult, is more harder than amal itself. To do good is not so difficult, but to keep good action is very difficult. It's very difficult. Imam Muhammad Baqir alayhi salatu wassalam narrates from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam this hadith. That Prophet said, now listen please carefully. What Prophet said? Prophet said, if someone says Subhanallah, Allah plants a tree for him in Jannah. And if someone says Alhamdulillah, Allah plants another tree for him in Jannah. And someone says, Alhamdulillah, Allah plants again another tree for him in Jannah. And if someone says and pronounces La ilaha illallah, Allah grants him another tree in Jannah, in Paradise. And whoever says Allahu Akbar, Allah plants for him another tree in Jannah. In other words, Prophet wanted to say, value of this zikr, which is very common zikr, Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, is so great that when you say these four zikrs, as a result, you get four trees in Jannah. Allahu Akbar. One of the people who were present there in this gathering of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know what he said? He said, okay, Ya Rasulullah, then we got plenty of trees in Jannah. We got big farms there, hundreds of thousands of trees there in Jannah. Because you see, every Subhanallah tree, every Alhamdulillah tree, every Allahu Akbar tree, every La ilaha illallah tree, every Allahu Akbar tree. So I got millions of trees there. You know how Prophet replied, very beautiful. Prophet said, yes, yes, you got plenty of trees in Jannah. But just mindful, just remember, just be careful that before you get to those trees, you have not burned them by fire you sent also behind them. Allahu Akbar. Huh? Yes, we got plenty of trees. You know, protection of amal. To save a good deed is very difficult. For example, you know, one day someone came to me and he was in need and he was in a difficult situation and nobody was there. I was all alone, but I put hand in my pocket. I brought 500 rand, gave it to that person purely and purely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure. Nobody was there to see. Very purely I gave. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, this amal is accepted. You heard a person in difficulty and hardship, he is gone. You got a great sabab and reward there because of your action. But you must understand, this action is like a living thing. You know, this hadith which I narrated for you is very interesting, brothers, please. Very thought-provoking. This symbolization, this exemplification that amal is like a tree, very beautiful. Very beautiful to understand. Tree requires water. Tree requires protection. Now you gave 500 rand. Nobody was there. You give it purely for Allah. You got a hell of a reward. No problem. After few days, after 1 week, 2 week, 1 month, 3 month, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, you sitting among the people, there was a talk to help someone. You said, oh, one day someone came to me, Allahu Akbar. Nobody was there. I quietly gave him 500 rand. Wassalam. That tree which you planted came down. Came down. Hadith says, came down. And then Hadith goes further. He says that not only among the people you sat and you said you wanted to show your pride, you wanted to show off, you wanted to say something about yourself. No, no, not only that. One day all of a sudden you came across to the same old man or some person who was in difficulty and hardship. And now you wanted to show or you wanted to say, you want to brag. You wanted to tell him, remember, I helped you. Allahu Akbar. Prophet says, Hadith says, that not only that reward is gone, but because of the insult you did, And the dignity of this man you took away among the people, Allahu Akbar, you have provided azab also for you. That's how the system of azab and sabab works. My brothers and sisters, please understand. This is Imam Ibn Abidin saying to us, Allahu Akbar. Ahsan al-a'mal is a amal which is protected, which is taken care. We do good things and then we waste and we destroy and we don't worry what will happen afterward. Allahu Akbar. So do good things, sustain good things and take care and protect your reward. Don't allow to be wasted or reversed even. Both are possible. Sometimes a person does a bad thing. A sin, guna. You commit a guna, you're going to commit a sin. But when you come inside the masjid, Allah, your head is down like that. Ya Allah, I'm that horrible person. Ya Allah, I'm that terrible person. I am the one who broke your law. I am the one who crossed your limit. I am the one who got arrogant against you. I am the one. This feeling is with you. This condition is with you. What a beautiful condition it is. What a beautiful status it is. In that well-known hadith to Abu Zar, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that sometimes ghaflat appears. Ghaflat means negligence. Negligence appears for one of the very, very pious servants of Allah. And you know why it appears? Because when this negligence happens or he misses something or he does something wrong, it shakes him. It brings him back to his... All of a sudden I was thinking, I'm very pure. I'm very clean. I never do anything wrong. I never go anywhere astray. But by a small mistake, a shock comes. He said, no, I'm nothing. So even sometimes negligence and ghaflat is a ni'mat. Allah, it reminds you who you are. It reminds you your weakness and our weaknesses. Allahu Akbar. Brothers and sisters, let's pray that may Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that purest of intentions and best of amal. Grant us tawfiq to sustain the amal. Grant us tawfiq to protect and preserve and save our amal and its rewards. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.